نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم.
That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alayhi mean you to say yeah. And I ask Allah to inspire in words that becomes the reason and means and the zari'ah of hidayah in this majlis. And that my words can reach to beyond, so that people, when they listen, it becomes the reason of hidayah and the reason for the salvation in the day of Qiyamah from the fire of Jahannam. Mm-hmm. I have read a Quranic ayat, and I ask Allah to inspire me words that becomes easy for me to explain this ayat of the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this world has created human beings in different regions, in different backgrounds, and with different colors, from different country around the world, different part of the world. Allah has kept these differences. Why has Allah kept these differences? When you see someone who is in a better position than you, who Allah has granted him and gifted him with more favors, who is more better than you, then what should you do? You should do sabr. You should do patience. You should do sabr. And if you see someone in an inferior position than you, who has less than you, who is eating less than you, who is spending less than you, then you should do shukr. You should do shukr to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why it comes in a hadith, a very blatant hadith, that Rasulullah, the sunnah method of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, was that when he used to go up the mountains, he used to read Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. And coming down the mountain, he used to read Subhanallah, Subhanallah, Subhanallah. The ulamas have written the wisdom behind it. They said that when you see something great, when you see someone huge, if you see someone very honored in the society, or you see something very amazing, for example, you saw the skyscraper, and you were looking at the skyscraper, and then you say, wow. Yes, this is what will come out anyone's mouth. Then what he's trying to say, the greatness of that thing, it comes into your heart. Now look at this, look at how they made this. That's why the wisdom behind this sunnah is that when you see something big, you should say Allahu Akbar, Allah is greater. Allah is greater. And a person, when he's in a good position, he never wants to come down. If a person is in a good position, he never wants to come down. A person, you go and ask a rich man. You go and ask a rich man. Yesterday he was rich. How would he feel to become poor today? He would say, no, that's impossible. How would I become poor? So a person to become inferior, to become degraded, to become less in life, people don't like this. That's why when you see something inferior, you should say Subhanallah. Allah is pure from all faults. So Allah amongst us has made this superior and inferior, so that we realize the Creator, we recognize the Creator. But today it has become vice versa. It's become the opposite. When we see someone in a superior position, we start hating that person automatically. If he's in a family member, if he's your relative, in our own relative, from one tradition of family tree, but someone from your family tree has become, mashallah, in a better position, and then what happens? Everyone in that family doesn't like him anymore. They say, look at him, he's big-headed. But this happens from the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's what Allah says in the Quran, لِلْرِجَالِ نَصِيبٌ مِمَّا اكْتَسَبُوا. Every man comes with whatever he is going to earn. Every person is being gifted whatever he's going to earn. Now the worstest illness, the worstest disease, and this disease has prevailed. This disease, brothers, please listen carefully. This disease has prevailed in every homes, every families, every street, every societies, and in every communities. This disease is enmity and envy and jealousy creating amongst us. In one time, our elders used to say, even a person, if he wasn't his own mother, brother, from the same mother, but even there used to be some sort of connection and bond that people never used to realize. Today, in the homes, brothers are not talking to brothers. Brothers are not talking to sisters. The uncle is not talking to the nephew. The nephew is not talking to the niece. This is what's happening amongst us. This has become a disease in the modern world today. Today they call it the so modern world. In the modern world today, it's become a disease. It's become a very great disease. That's why Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to Hazrat Anas ibn Malik. Hazrat Anas ibn Malik, even though he was young in age, Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal, he said, he was one of those Sahabis, al-mukthirina fil hadith. There were six great Sahabis who were the most narrators of the hadiths. One of them was Anas ibn Malik. Hazrat Anas. So Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to Hazrat Anas, please listen to this hadith. Ya bunayya, in qadarta an tusbiya aw tumsiya wa laysa fi qalbika ghashun fa'al dhalika fa innahu min sunnati wa man ahya sunnati faqad ahabbani wa man ahabbani faqad ma'iya fil jannah. He said, oh Anas, oh my child, ya bunayya, this is so much affection in this word, ya bunayya, oh my child. Ibni is the word Arabic. Oh my child, Ibni. But Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, oh ya bunayya, oh my child. In so much affection, I can't express to you how much love Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to Hazrat Anas. He said, if you can do one morning and one evening, one morning and one evening, if you can spend one whole day in your heart without any grief, without any enmity, without any hatred, without any jealousy, without any malice, without any enmity amongst yourself and your Muslim brothers and around the world, then فَفَعَلْ ذَلِكَ. Do this, because this is my sunnah. This is my sunnah. Which means Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam never ever in his heart for forget a second will not give justice. A second will not give justice to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But I'm saying not beyond a second or less than a second that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam ever in his heart had any kind of grudge, enmity, grief for anyone, not just Muslims, for the non-Muslims as well. So brothers, this is a disease. And not having this kind of quality, if a person has, believe me, it goes beyond boundaries. It goes beyond boundaries. You might be thinking, what is he saying? Having this quality, it is more greater and better than giving £1,000 in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Having this quality, it is more better to pray salat all night. Having this quality, it is better walking with the tasbih in the street. Because Abu Darda, he says, Ala uhaddithukum. Shall I not tell you? It's like warning. Shall I not tell you? Ala uhaddithukum bi khayrin bima huwa khayrun lakum min as-sadaqati aw as-salat. Shall I not tell you? something that is more beyond greater than praying and giving charity. Allah, salahu dhatul bayn, living amongst each other, living amongst each other with muhabba, with love, with open heart, with a clean heart, staying clean amongst each other. Then he said, Ala innal bughdha hiya al-halik. He said that when you start from the day you start becoming enemy of someone, from the day you start becoming enemy of someone, from that day you should know that you have destroyed yourself. You haven't destroyed the person, but you have destroyed yourself. That's why our mashayikh, our ulama, they say, if you have some sort of enmity, some sort of problem, some sort of grudge of someone, quickly rectify it. Quickly fix your problems amongst each other. Start talking to him. Make salam to him. Make dua for him. Make salam to him. Start talking to him. Make dua to him. And tell him. Our ustad, one of my ustad, they used to say, if you backbited about someone, you can't say, oh brother, I've said so and so this on so and so time about you. Then you say, oh, you said this about me? Don't say this. You go to him, you start talking to him, and you say, brother, anything between me and you, I have done or have done intentionally or unintentionally, please forgive me. So he will say, why are you saying this? Forgive me as well. So he'll become humble as well. If you become humble, your brother becomes humble. If you become humble, then your brother becomes humble. So he say, Abu Darda said, Ala inna al-bughdha hiya al-halik. When you become, when the enmity has created amongst you, it will destroy. And don't let the tree grow. If this is growing, and it starts growing and growing and growing in your heart, brothers, you'll be going so far from Deen that Allah Ta'ala says that before you die, don't come to me without a clean heart. Without a clean heart. إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهَ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. Don't come to me without a clean heart. Clean everything. Pay off your debts. Pay off your debts with your brothers and your Muslim sisters in this world. Because if you're going to pay off your debts in Akhirah, you will have to pay off with your a'mal. You will have to pay off with your good deeds if you have good deeds. If you have good deeds. So I will say, last hadith, three things. A person, that if a person stays away from these three things, then surely maybe in the day of Qiyamah, Allah through His infinite mercy, He might have mercy on you. Number one, وَمَنْ مَاتَ لَا يُشْرِكُ بِاللَّهِ شَيْءٍ. Whoever dies without doing the shirk of Allah, associating partner with Allah. Number two, وَمَنْ سَحَى وَيَتَّبِعُ السَّحَرَةَ. A person who does magic. Magic has become a common phenomenon in the communities and the societies, in the homes and in the families, to destroy people's life, to destroy relation between husband and wives, to destroy relation in the families. Sahara comes. فَإِنَّهُ مِنَ الْمُوبِقَاتِ. It is amongst the greatest sins, and it will destroy all your deeds in the day of Qiyamah. Those people who commit magic, black magic, it is haq. And the third one, who has an enmity. If a person dies, and whilst he's alive, he's not rectified between his brother or sister, or his Muslim brother and sister, and he's not said, ask for forgiveness, whilst he's alive, then only Allah knows in the day of Qiyamah if Allah will forgive him or not. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make you a new person.